Hey there! Welcome to Jaga tutorial series. In this video, we're going to learn how to create a tabbed form via the multi-paged form. The multi-paged form enables one to incorporate multiple forms in one single form. Please note that the multi-paged form is only available on Professional and Enterprise Edition. Okay, let's begin. First, log in to the default administrator account. The default admin user's username and password are both admin. Once you've logged in, click on Design New App. Let's create a new app called Multi-Paged Form. As a best practice, ensure the app ID is in camel case. Once you've clicked on the Save button, you will be directed to the Design App page. We will begin by creating one of the two tabbed forms before we create the main form. The main form will be the one to incorporate these two tabbed forms. Click on the Create New Form button, and for learning purposes, let's call this form Tab 1. As for the form table name, we will declare a prefix to be used across all forms in this app. Click on Save and you will be directed to the form builder. Hover to the top right corner of the section and click on Edit. Let's call this section Address Details. Click the OK button. Next, drag and drop the text field element. Now, let's use the copy-paste feature in Jaga to copy another text field. Then, drag and drop a text area onto the canvas. Edit the first text field's properties, and set it as the company registration number for the ID and label fields, and click OK. Next, edit the properties of the following text field. We'll name this as phone for its ID and label fields. And finally, edit the properties of the text area. Key in the ID and label of the text field as address. Once we've added the relevant fields, preview the form if you want to see how it looks like in runtime, then close the preview, save the form, and close this form builder. Now, let's make the second tab form a little bit interesting. We'll create a grid that allows users to key in multiple rows of records in a table grid. Before we begin, let's maximize the overlay to the full screen. Click on Create New Form, fill up the details for Tab 2, and click on Save to bring up the form builder. We'll drag and drop a grid element here. Oh, let's change the section label to Contacts. Alright, now let's edit the grid properties. Let's give the grid an ID by calling it Contacts. Empty the label and add three rows in the Options field. We're going to name the three columns as follows: first name, last name, and email. Click on the OK button to save the configuration and let's see how it'll look like in the preview. Alright, click on Save and close this form builder. Now let's build the main form that will incorporate the two forms we've just created. We'll call this the main form, fill up the necessary details, and click on Save. Once in the form builder, let's begin by changing the section label to Company Details. Next, we'll drag and drop a text field into the canvas. Edit its properties, and we'll name this as company name. Okay, drag and drop the multi-paged form element and edit its properties. Let's give it an ID. Now, in the number of pages field we can define how many pages or tabs we want to display. As we've created two forms, we'll set this to 2. Click on the next button, and we will see the configuration for the first page. For the label field, let's call this page as address. In the field below, select Tab 1. This will ensure that the address page will display the selected form in which in this case, is Tab 1. Now, for this field, parent form field to keep child form ID. This needs some explaining. Whenever a user submits a form, the data will be stored in the respective table within the database. On top of that, Jaga will generate a unique ID associated with that data. This unique ID, or primary key, will make it easier to uniquely identify this record. and it'll be used to retrieve said information, edit it, or even deleting the record. As we know, the main form incorporates both tab 1 and tab 2 forms. Now, if we take that into our multi-paged form, when user submits, it'll store into three different tables with three unique IDs. We'll need a way so that the main form is aware that respective row in the tab forms, 1 and 2, is related to its main form ID. In this case, we should add two columns in the main form to store the tab form IDs. This way, the relation between the main form and the two tab forms are known. As the tab forms are a subset of the main form, it's considered as a child, while the main form is considered as a parent. Going back to the multi-paged form properties, the phrase parent form field to keep child form ID will be clearer. This means we need a field ID in the main form to store the primary key of tab 1 form. The data on this page will be loaded based on the ID retrieved from this field. Although we don't have a field for this, it'll automatically create one based on the input here. Let's name it tab 1 underscore key. Click on the next button to view the second page. Let's call this page contacts. Set the form field to tab 2. And for the parent form field, we'll name it as tab 2 underscore key. Click on the OK button to save the configuration. You can click on preview to see how it'll look like in runtime. As you can see, the pages are displaying the respective forms we've created. Looks like it's displaying in wizard mode, we'll need to change that. Let's head back to the multi-paged form properties and click on the advanced options. Under the UI section, change the display mode to tab. Okay, let's take a look again in the preview. Great! Save the form and create a CRUD via the Generate App button. Let's launch the user view to see it working in runtime. Now we need to see if the records will be stored upon saving the record. Click on New and fill up the fields. Once you're done, click on Save. Looks like we'll need to modify what's being displayed here. Click on the admin bar. Ensure the quick edit mode is on. Then, click on the green highlight called list, main form to open up the respective list in the data list builder. Let's remove all the unwanted columns first. Currently, the data that can be displayed is the fields from the main form. We'll need to change that. Click on the Source button on the top left. Ensure the Advanced Form Data Binder is selected, then click Next. As the main form is the target form, let's join it with Tab 1. Click on the plus sign. Select Tab 1's table name, which is MPF underscore 1. In the field column, select Tab 1's ID. And in the Join field ID, we'll select Main Form's Tab 1 underscore key. Click on the OK button. Now, you'll be able to view data from both the main form and tab 1. Let's add the company registration number, the address, and the phone number. Click on preview to see how it'll look like. Looks good. Oh wait, the labels on this column need to be changed. Close the preview tab, and let's rename the column labels. Let's take a look in preview mode. Alright, close the preview tab and click on Save. Close the data list builder and let's refresh the page. Looks great. Let's click on Edit to make sure all the data is there. Good job. We are done with this tutorial. Thanks for watching.